In this video, we will be overviewing the BREWHA touchscreen power box. First, we will be looking at the hardware, and then we will be overviewing how to program the controller. The BREWHA touchscreen power boxes come in a rugged, splash-proof, wall-mounted polycarbonate enclosure. They have a clear plastic lid so that you can see your touchscreen at all times, and they are CSA inspected and certified for safety. Beneath the touchscreen are two switches. The one on the left is the main power switch. The one on the right is for controlling the pump. At the bottom of the box, there are the heating element receptacles. There's a receptacle for the pump. There's a receptacle for the chilling device, such as the BREWHA temperature control valve, another pump, or the chiller. And there is a receptacle for the sensor cable. On the larger controllers, there is also the receptacle for the water level sensor. Installation is really straightforward. There are four mounting brackets to mount the control box to the wall, and all your electrician needs to do is to cut a hole in the side of the box to bring the right power supply and connect it to the distribution block. Now let's turn the power box on and see how to program the controller. The program was designed to be powerful, flexible, and to simplify your brewing. On the main menu screen, there are four options. We're going to start at the bottom and work our way up. If we press settings, the first setting option is the default temperature unit. You can select Fahrenheit or Celsius. Under temperature control settings, there's two options. Reduce power within is the point at which the controller is going to start winding down the heating elements so that you don't overshoot your target temperature. Currently, it's set to 4 Fahrenheit, so if you're heating to 160 Fahrenheit, at 156, it's going to start slowing it down. The minimum power level during the mash is the bottom level that the heating elements are going to allow, the power output during the mash. Fermentation control settings, this is the hysteresis. That's the gap that the controller is going to allow before either turning chilling or heating on. Currently, it's set to 2 degrees Fahrenheit. Which means that if your fermentation temperature is 70 Fahrenheit, at 72 it's going to start to cool, and at 68 it's going to start to heat. It's recommended not to go less than 1 degree Fahrenheit or half a degree Celsius for this, otherwise the two can start fighting each other. Default recipe just lets you program in every time you go to load a new program in, what settings are going to load by default. And display settings, there's the display timeout, when the screen will go blank, currently set to 30 minutes, and display brightness, you can control the brightness or dimness. System info, there's one setting in here that you'll need to do one time, and that's the post-boil cooling temp of your water, the fermentation cooling temp of your water. Most customers are gonna be using municipal water, so post-boil, it'll be the temperature of your municipal water. And if you're using a chiller during fermentation, it'll be the temperature of your chiller. The program just uses these to calculate the amount of time that is left when cooling. And it can also use it to set the bottom level that if you try to go below that point, it's gonna just give you a warning that you're trying to cool lower than your coolant is gonna allow, your chilling media is gonna allow. So we go back to main menu, we save the settings. Manual control can be useful during, if you've got a separate vessel that you need to heat, like a hot liquor kettle. It can be useful if you're distilling, or if you're in the middle of a brew program and something happens that you want to just switch over to manual control to be able to maintain a temperature for an indefinite period, say. Target temperature you can control. The element mode, it's on auto. On or off, auto will raise the temperature currently with the end criteria being none. It'll raise the temperature to your target temperature and just maintain it. Other end criteria could be a timer. You can change the timer in there. Temperature, that's where it's gonna hit the temperature and stop. Or time at temp, how long you want it to remain at the temperature. load program. There are four programs that come with already coded into the programmer or into the controller. And these are based on the recipes that are at the back of the BREWHA manual. New program, there are three steps for the mash profile. There's the single infusion, there's the infusion with mash out, and the multi-step. We'll go infusion with mash out. Heat to 158 Fahrenheit. We're gonna raise that up a little bit. We'll put that up to 160. The end criteria is obviously temperature. Max heating power, chiller status off, finish alarm on, and approve next. Approve next is a screen that just pops up and lets you go to the next step. Obviously for here, when you're heating up to mash, you don't wanna go into the mash period because you gotta mash in. This is gonna be your mash period. You mash at 152 for 60 minutes, max heating power. It'll be the minimum or what you set it at here. And we're gonna do a finish alarm on and approve next on because we wanna check to see if saccharification is complete by using an iodine or a starch test. May wanna go a little longer on the mash. This is raising the temperature to 168 for mashing out. And then we will have a rest at 5 minutes. With the BIAX system, as you start to raise the mash colander, you can start to you can start by raising it to your mash out temperature. Once the colander is out of the wort, of course, you can start to raise it towards your boil temp. So let's go to the boil. Heat to 208 Fahrenheit at 100%. That's taking it from your mash out or the end of the mash up to your boil. We only heat it to 208 because we want to stop shy of the boil to make sure that we're there so that we don't get the boil over happening in the fermenter or in the kettle. And so we'll raise it to 208, then we've got a finish alarm on and the approve next step on. We're gonna boil for 65 minutes, 80% output. You can change the output if you wanna boil off more or if you want a more rapid boil, just by adjusting the more or less rapid boil, you can just adjust the percent output there. Boil addition alarms, these are your hop addition, or we're gonna add one here at 5 minutes for our Irish moss. And then fermentation, we're gonna cool to 66 Fahrenheit. Finish alarm on and approve next on. Once the temperature drops down to our target temperature, we're gonna drop the proteins out of the fermenter, and then we're gonna aerate with the aeration stone in the bottom, and the aeration is gonna distribute the wort and move the wort around inside the fermenter and make sure that the temperature is all equalized in there. There's no stratification. At the end, we're gonna, our fermentation period is gonna be 12 days. Throughout any of this, if you just select the middle item, so you can go up or down on the left or right, if you do the middle, it changes between seconds, minutes, hours, days, seconds, and goes back and forth. So for fermentation, it's gonna be the days, 12 days, we're done. Then we crash it to 42 Fahrenheit, and we rest there for a couple days. If we want to add another step, we just press down, and that's it. We save our awesome, I guess it's awesome is with an E, is it not? Awesome space ale. Okay, we gotta add an E. Awesome ale. Save. Load menu. There's two here. We're gonna delete this one. Delete recipe. Yes. Okay, awesome ale. There it is. So to load a program, we just go into the load program. There's our awesome ale. We select it. There's the summary. We can edit it if we want. We can delete it. And we press run program, start, and away we go. That's the BREWHA touchscreen controller. If you have any questions about it, please send them to us using the form on the website. And thank you for watching.